few people have ever been to my hometown of Colstrip. In fact, it's not even my hometown, because if you want to send me a letter, you have to mail it to Forsyth. Forsyth is our address. But there's six post offices that are closer to where our ranch headquarters are than Forsyth. If you want to call me on the phone, you got to look under the Rosebud directory. But the closest town is Colstrip. That's where I went to grade school and high school, where our kids went to school, and our grandchildren, are, a couple of them, are going to school there too. But it's not along any highway that gets much traffic. It's kind of between a couple of them. So people have heard of Colstrip sometimes in different contexts, but they've never been there. If you haven't been there, let me take you on a tour of it with a poem I call Things of Intrinsic Worth. Remember that sand rock on Emil's Creek where Dad carved his name in 13? It's been blasted down into rubble and interred by a dragline machine. And where Fatals lived at the old Myler place, where us kids stole melons at night, they dozed it up in a funeral pyre and torched it. It's gone, all right. And the sea on the hill and the water tanks are now classified reclaimed land. They were thinking of building a golf course out there, so I understand. And the old Egan homestead's an ash pond that they say is 80 feet deep. And the branding grill at the Douglas camp is underneath a spoil heap. And across the creek is a tipple now where they load coal onto a train. And the May West rock on Hay Coulee, just black and white snapshots remain. There's a railroad loop and a coal storage shed where the bison kill site used to be. The Guy place is gone. Ambrose's too. And Beulah Farley's a ranch refugee. But things are booming. We've got this new school that's envied across the whole state. And when folks up and ask, how's things going down there? Hell, I grin like a fool and say, great. Great God, how we're doing. We're rolled and then dough as they tear and they ravage the earth. And nobody knows. Nobody cares about things of intrinsic worth.